Howdy, folks. Got a little NCAA 2008 on the 360 here. I'm gonna try a night game. Not that it really matters, but about to turn that into music here a little bit. Cool thing about this game, or the interesting thing about this game, is that
we're in Aggieland, College Station, Texas, and we're looking forward to bringing you a great game. We're going to enjoy great weather in tonight's game as the skies are clear and the temperature is just right for...
Interesting thing about this game is that if you look at NCAA 2007 on the 360, it's like 2007, but it has the graphics are not as good. There's a reason for that. NCAA 2007 had better graphics, better stadiums, but it came at the cost of frame rate. So this game kind of fixed a couple of those issues. And the stadiums don't look bad in this game, but they definitely look better in 2007.
Go to work at the 26-yard line. Bradford comes to the line with three.
I think that 2008 had probably some of the better gameplay feel out of a lot of the 360 PS3 era. I think 2008 and 2007 had a better gameplay flow. Like the hits and the running were a little bit more, they felt like your players had some weight to them. They didn't feel like they were puppets or anything like they did in the later NCAA games. So there's good things to be said about this game. One thing that apparently is a problem in this game is the interception rate. Apparently there's a lot of interceptions. So I went into sliders and changed that around. Okay, they got three wide. I'll go dime. Two man under. And I do have the rosters set up for this year too. 2007 rosters. This year A&M had Javorski Lane. I think he played for the Dolphins a little while. Javorski Lane was just a monster of a running back. I remember going to a game in 2007 and got to see Javorski Lane. That guy would just run people over, just knock them straight out. I think his break tackle rating is like a 99. So they definitely took note of him.
From their own 45-yard line, second down.
Bradford lines up in the shotgun. Bradford back to pass. He'll dump this one off. And he's tackled at about the 49. They got 4 yards on that one.
Third and two. It looks like they're probably going to try to run this one. I'll stay in a 4-4.
From their own 49-yard line. It's third down. Bradford steps to the line of scrimmage.
Thought they were going to go to the left.
Bradford hands it off. They just keep moving the chains.
Bit by bit, my friend. It starts with the short pickups on first and second down, and then you get the rest on third down. In the process, you start to wear the defense down, and that's when you break the big one.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45. Bradford on first down.
Nice. Speaking of interceptions.
And just a great interception by the cornerback.
Well, that's big time. He made a great read on the quarterback and got in there for the pick.
I turned off the game music just because I don't want to get hit with a copyright claim on some meaningless track somewhere.
From their own 31-yard line, first down. The offense lines up with three wide receivers. McGee gives it up the middle. He gets hit out of bounds at the 36. They get about 5 yards from the halfback. It's second and four to go.
Here we go.
McGee comes to the line.
Time for Jaworski Lane.
Two backs in the eye. Tosses it out.
He wasn't that fast, but
he makes it out to maybe the 39-yard.
He had enough speed to just.
Gain by the running back.
I guess it was more weight. Like, he was just dense. I remember watching a play that he had in
defensive line and get after a lot of plays in the running game.
So it's third down, and this,
I think it was in Miami. And I think he cracked some guy's face mask.
He has two tight ends. The Aggies audible.
This is bad.
You'll get it again. Oh, he got nailed on that one.
I can certainly trust him to fall forward.
The key to that play is a good blocking up front by the Hog Mollies.
You're right, and those are the kind of runs that you need to have a successful offense.
From their own 44-yard line, it's first down.
See if I can get a little play action. Maybe Bennett or Thomas. Quick.
Makes to the back. Surveys the field.
Just have to run it myself.
He takes off. Knocked out of bounds at the 49-yard line. So the keeper.
The players in this game feel a little bit slower than you might expect. So it kind of takes a little bit to get used to.
Second and three. Ball on the 49.
Second and three. I'll try to punch it in as close as I can.
Inside you.
Or just get run over like that.
They'll drop him for a short loss there.
1 yard loss. Oh, man. He'll feel that.
Third and four.
That's called making a statement. When you get into the backfield like that and put somebody on their back, it really sends a message.
The offense faces another third down as they line it up. The Aggies line up in an I formation. Hand off up the middle. They tackle him there.
Fourth and two.
And they'll still be a little short of the first down line.
At midfield. I kind of want to go for it, but
they get some positive yards, but this defensive line really.
It's 2 yards.
Yep, great play by the defense to step up and force the fourth down.
So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Well, I'm not sure I really agree with this call to go for it, but
I think I'm going to go ahead and try. I got it.
They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by
the team against
I really like what they're doing by
a team that
on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
I didn't have to worry about too much on offense. Maybe I would have been a little more conservative, but I was already past half of midfield. And it's against Oklahoma. I definitely don't want to not capitalize on my first possession, so I gambled and I won.
Goodson takes the give. He just tackled at the 31-yard line. They go with a run, and that'll be a gain of 9. 9-yard gain on the play. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. McGee is lined up under center. Broke away from one. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line.
Telling you.
So they keep it on the ground for another first down.
And this defense is having all kinds of problems stopping this guy on the ground.
Yep, no surprises here, Kurt. This kid has really carried the load on this drive.
It's the 11th play of the drive. First down, Texas A&M is going with the offset eye backfield.
Ooh.
Lane lost the ball. Clark with a recovery. They narrowly escaped there.
Got punished that time for running the same play. That was close.
And we've reached the end of the first quarter, still no score.
Need to get a little bit of a passing game going.
We're at the 12th play of the drive. It's second down. Texas A&M lines up in the offset eye. Play action. He scrambled. Rolling out to the right side. Complete. And that sets them up with a first and goal.
Did you see what I saw there, Coach?
Pretty good pass to the tight end.
It looked like to me that he just got beaten man-to-man cover.
He sure did. These guys are going to have to do a better job of locking down their man and preventing passes like that.
First down and goal to go. Ball on the 6-yard line. Backfield's in an offset eye formation. Give to the tailback. They'll bring him down right around the 6-yard line. And the halfback's got no.
I think 11 was a little bit too thick around the waist to fit through that hole.
Here's play number 14 of this drive. Second down. I formation here.
Snake eyes! Snake eyes! Ready! Thunder! Thunder!
The play clock's at 0. They took too much time.
I don't have my audible set up.
And anytime there's a delay of game, it's usually because they were late getting the right personnel on the field.
Second down. They're 10 yards away.
Guess I'll try to get my penalty yardage back.
McGee hands it off. And he's tackled at the 3.
Or just get real close to the goal line. I'll take that.
Third and goal from the 2-yard line. Texas A&M is going with the offset eye backfield. McGee hands it off straight ahead. Touchdown, Texas A&M. The halfback just.
I was close, but I kind of just rode gravity in.
The offensive lineman just pancaked the defense on that one.
And they line up for the point after. Texas A&M is up by 6, and he converts the extra point. So we take a moment to check out the Pontiac drive summary. Texas A&M ready to kick this one off. And it's off. He jukes. He's taken down at the 28-yard line. You know the offense will be looking to do better this time out.
You know, this offense can't afford another turnover here.
Right now, it's only
going 4 wide.
If they keep giving the ball away, then this deficit will go up in a hurry, Coach.
Let's try a cover 2.
28-yard line. First down. 4 wide. Bradford lines up in the shotgun.
Option.
4 wide formation.
The option left.
The safety made the tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
I reckon. Okay, now they're going five wide. A little play action and throw the fade route. This will have to go dime.
Used to be. That's right, Lee. These guys are shooting up there when they see run, and it only takes one
time over two.
To get them out of position and take it to the house.
They line up at the 28. It's second down. The Aggies bring in their dime package. Back to pass. Peterson knocks it down. Nice job knocking that one down.
You're right. Good job there on the coverage. That's just what they teach you to do.
Going back to four wide. Do some man coverage. Keep tight on them.
From the gun, Bradford, back to throw, stepping up, got hit as he threw. It's complete. Tackle at about the 41. Not too bad a pass there.
Nope, not at all. That time he puts enough air under this thing to fill that big blip up there. But somehow it came down on target, and he got a nice little gain out of it.
First and 10. Ball on the 41.
Sam Bradford. I think he played for the Vikings for a while.
He's got two tight ends in the set. Bradford looking to throw on.
Kind of turned out to be Did you play for the Vikings?
Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
I can't remember, but he turned out to be a little bit of a journeyman.
To make a tackle before he can go anywhere after the catch.
Second and 7 coming up here. Ball on their own 45. Hand off to the right. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Great open field tackle.
And the offense loses a yard or two.
Nice job of plugging up all the gaps and the possible cutback lanes by the defense.
They'll line it up again on third down. Oklahoma comes out in the shotgun. They line up in the shotgun. Bradford. Back to pass. He throws on the run.
Somebody get him.
To the 20. To the 10. He's all the way. Touchdown. Nicely designed play to the wide receiver, and it got him 6.
You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offensive coordinator.
This kid had no problem getting separation on that play. He was wide open when he caught that touchdown pass.
The extra point to tie this game up. Kicks away, and he adds the extra point. And now we're going to take a look at the Pontiac drive summary. Hartley has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He sends it downfield.
All right.
From the 8-yard line. And down he goes.
Definitely want to avoid any need to get into fourth down conversion territory.
Defense has made any adjustments to stop the run game.
Yeah, I'll tell you, they sure couldn't stop them from going down and scoring on that last drive, right, Coach?
The offense will take over at the 24-yard line.
2 minutes.
First and 10. Lane lines up in the deep back. I formation. Gives it to the back. Tries to juke. He can scoop. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back.
Flipping. Great.
Preach fundamentals every week, and then have someone called for clipping. That penalty really is going to set them back.
It's first down and a lot. McGee comes to the line under center. I formation.
Oh, God, it's a blitz.
Off the fake. He gets sacked on the play. It looks like the defensive end that got in there.
Yes, it was. He did a wonderful job of fighting off blocks to bring the quarterback down.
But not too much loss. They only dropped about 2 on the play. The offense in a hole here after the second and long. McGee is in the shotgun. He's got 4 receivers split out wide. McGee still has it. He's going to try and scramble. Brought down at the 30. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense.
Third and 4.
The result is a nice game.
McGee fakes the handoff. Ooh.
Caught and he's hit immediately. Good yardage on that completion.
The interesting thing about this play is the fact that they ran the same play two times in a row. And I'll tell you what that means. That means that the coach has seen some sort of a mismatch out there.
First and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. The Aggies set up in the gun. McGee changes the play at the line. McGee back to throw. He's rolling right.
Right there. Come on, Taylor.
Down the sideline. And they bring him down at the 8-yard line.
Hey, if they were ever looking for a playmaker, then they found one in this wideout.
Yeah, he really broke it open on that kick. Don't be surprised.
Man, Stephen McGee was a great QB.
Texas A&M just took their first time out. And the big pickup through the air has made it first and goal. The Aggies line up with an offset eye backfield. McGee hands it off straight ahead.
Boom.
Touchdown, Aggies. He showed some explosive power on that run to the end zone.
He's a very physical fullback, but he's got the grace of a halfback.
And what makes this run even better is that this defense should have had him down in the backfield. But
I wasn't expecting to get in there, but
and he has a touchdown.
Fullback made it happen.
So the kicking team will line up for the point after. And he hits the PAT. And here's the Pontiac drive summary.
There's still 47 seconds, and OU still has all three timeouts, so I'm assuming that they're gonna try to take a couple shots downfield.
Well, fellas, what do you tell your offense after moving the ball so well on that last possession?
You don't tell them anything. They moved the ball very well. It's the defense who needs some talking to.
They really just need to cover better in the secondary. There's no reason why these receivers should be so wide open.
They'll start this drive at the 29-yard line. First and 10. The Sooners line up with five receivers. Drops back to pass.
What a QB draw.
They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
They line up at the 27. Second down.
Surprised they didn't call any timeouts. Gonna draw it again.
Here he goes. Tackle made at the 37-yard line. The offense calls a timeout, and they'll have two remaining.
A little too late for that, but.
From their own 37-yard line, third down. They back off in coverage, so we'll probably get one last heave to the end zone here before halftime. Third and short, and they'll throw for it. Complete. It's the junior. Tackle right around the 40.
A little bit of mismanagement by OU, I'd say.
And we've reached halftime here. The score at the break. Texas A&M, 14. Oklahoma, 7.
Check out some of the game stats. See what Stephen McGee's up to. 4 out of 4 for 99 yards, 307 rating. Yeah, anytime you see completion to attempts being this low, you're probably watching me play a game because I'm pretty conservative when it comes to passing. See what Sam Bradford's up to. 7 out of 9. Okay.
And it's off. Taken from the 10. And he's tackled at the 27-yard line. Here comes the offense as they look to find the end zone yet again.
All right. So, I think I can probably try to slow it down a little bit because I'm one touchdown ahead. I can bleed the clock. It might work out in my favor. Defender jumped the line.
Defensive front got a good push and knocked that offensive line backwards.
It's second down now and 13 to go. Texas A&M lines up in the offset eye.
Let's go.
He gets another carry and he's taken down at the 30. Lane gets 6 yards on the carry. From their own
30-yard line. Need at least a 7-yard pass.
Formation in the backfield.
Looking for somebody in the backfield, hopefully.
On play action. Short pass, right side.
Nice. Trusty fullback's got some hands.
You know, it's really easy to overlook those guys on the line.
Yeah, the defense came after them, and those linemen held them long enough for the quarterback to throw for a first down.
Line up at the 41. First down.
The 5 out of 5.
Line up with an offset eye backfield. Lane gets the call. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. That was well defended by this defense.
Hey, that linebacker made a nice play. But what about all those big guys up front on the defensive line? They're good too, boy.
Well, they created the play this time, Coach. The offensive line is so concerned with their penetrating abilities that these linebackers are able to roam free and make plays like that.
And now he's going to run. He's knocked out of bounds. Around the 42-yard line.
I was thinking about passing it, but that would have been a dangerous pass. 39.
So another third down upcoming for the
offense. If McGee can stay perfect.
Oklahoma brings in their nickel package. McGee drops back, looks, rolls to the left.
Oh, here it is. I'm just going to run for this one.
He's going to take off.
Ooh. Remember, Stephen McGee was a pretty decent runner. Nice little juke there.
Down 10 yards to go. Ball on the 39. McGee is lined up under center.
They're definitely putting a lot of guys in the box.
98 Weasel. 98 Weasel. McGee hands off. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. They get 3 yards on the play.
It's a nice stop there by the defense.
Yeah, the outside linebacker was coming on the run blitz, and it caused some confusion on the offensive line.
It's 2nd and 6. Texas A&M is going with the offset eye backfield. McGee with a nice play fake. Rolls right. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. Again, this kid got into the backfield for the sack.
This offense really has to do a better job of protecting their quarterback.
I know I missed some opportunities here. Man. Oh my god, I was waiting for this fullback to be open, but I just couldn't see him and I didn't want to just toss it over there. I was looking for, I think this was the A receiver. Man. That might have been a touchdown. I mean, this was certainly a touchdown right here.
Even when he hasn't gotten to the quarterback, he always seems like he's right near the quarterback.
I'm going to run it again.
This young man is having a terrific game.
McGee is under center. McGee goes with the play fake.
Nice.
It's complete. He's taken down around the 36-yard line. He hits his man, but they'll be well short.
Fourth and six. I think I need to take 3 points here. A little too far to the left. See if I can make it.
Defense does a nice job of shutting it down that time. Great play recognition by the D.
They'll call on the field goal unit. This one 53 yards away. It has the distance. He barely snuck that over the
I didn't even realize I was 50 yards away.
That kick didn't look like it had enough mustard to make it over that crossbar, Kirk.
Yep, he literally didn't have more than a foot to spare. But this offense will take points.
All right. Being up 10 points, it should put a little bit more pressure on OU.
First and 10. Bradford lines up in the shotgun. He's got four receivers in the formation. Texas A&M lines up.
Somebody get him.
Patrick on the inside handoff, and he's taken down at the 36. So they get about three on the draw. It's second and 7. Ball on the 36. Bradford steps
Ooh.
To the line of scrimmage. Three receivers split out. Murray gets the carry. He didn't get much on that.
That offensive lineman really got a good push on the line, but running back kind of made a mistake. Third and 8.
Defensive line is in tight. He drops back. Throws it on the run. He gets hit out of bounds at the 48. Well, that was one of the best catches we've seen all day, guys.
Great concentration to go up and get that one.
And more importantly, it's a first down.
So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it.
I was thinking a little bit about that.
He was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell.
Can't even see his feet, though.
Put down or not.
So after some discussion, the call on the field is reversed.
I guess they got it right.
It's fourth down. Oklahoma lining up the punt. Peterson back to return it. Hunts it away.
Oh my God. I cannot believe that.
Coach, what can you do to avoid those turnovers?
Well, you just got to get back to the fundamentals.
You got to get some blocking is what you need to do. Poor guy. Look, number 18. A little shrug or something. A little push. 27 just gets clobbered. Boom. That's one of those helmet popping hits they needed to put back in the game. Need to check that kid for concussion protocol. Doesn't know where he's at.
Players, that means hanging on to the football.
Get that guy some help, please. All right. Now we got to make a goal line stand.
Bradford comes to the line under center. Single back backfield. The Sooners use motion. Gives it left side.
About 4 yards on the counter to the halfback.
Gain of 4 on the play.
They line up at the 16. Second down. Oklahoma lines up in a double tight set. Patrick alone in the backfield. Bradford with a nice play fake. Throws a bullet. And this one's broken up. Nice job getting a hand on that one.
Third and 6. Good
play there to get a hand on the football by the defense.
It's third down and 6 to go. Ball on the 16-yard line. The Sooners come out in a shotgun.
Wow. Steps back to pass. They went for a QB power run.
What happens when the protection breaks down up front?
Yeah, but coach, I think the quarterback has to release the ball quicker, or he's going to get pounded.
But AI play picking, a little questionable in this game.
It's fourth down. The field goal attempt will be about a 37-yarder. Kicks up. And he got it.
The field goal attempt is good.
That score leads us to our Pontiac.
Well, I'll take that over 7.
Oklahoma ready to kick this one off. Brown and Franks back ready to return.
All right, guys, gonna be some blocks here.
Brought down at the 28-yard line. This offense lost the ball by way of a fumble the last time they had it.
The offense has to be conscious of protecting that football.
All right, I want to switch to clock eater mode now.
Well, unless your team gets the turnover.
McGee hands off. They bring him down in the backfield. And the linebacker comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
Yeah, and that time the defense got him to go backwards.
From their own 28-yard line, second down, Texas A&M lines up in the offset eye.
Wow, he's right there.
They were bringing a heavy rush on that one.
Brad, that's what happens if the quarterback holds the ball too long, waiting for his receivers to get open.
We've played 3, and we're locked in a tight one with a score. Texas A&M, 17.
Third and 14.
Oklahoma,
10. Definitely going to have to pass it.
It's third down and 14 yards to go now after that setback by the sack. McGee lines up in the shotgun. He has 4 receivers. McGee steps back to pass. Tipped away.
Ooh.
Nice job there to bring up a fourth down.
Pretty good throw here by the quarterback, but he couldn't quite get it in there. That was a nice job.
I'd have thrown that sooner, maybe would have made it.
So it's fourth down.
All right, got to play defense now.
Ready to put this one away. Smith, back deep to return. He hits a low one there. Smith takes it to 36. Gets past the tackler. Whoa, he just took a licking. The offense goes back out onto the field after picking up a field goal on their last drive.
Anytime you can put points on the board, things are going in the right direction.
From their own 41-yard line, first down. The Aggies bring in their dime package. The Sooners come out with 2 tight ends. The quarterback is in the shotgun. Here's the options. Taking back a yard.
Took the dive just to make sure he was going down.
Second and 11 coming up. Ball on their own 40. The quarterback's in the gun with 3 receivers in the set. Gets out to around the 48. And that was a nice run. Kirk, that was a great job by that big offensive line.
Yeah, it really was, Brad. And also, a nice read by the
ball. Put a few more guys in the box.
When you break one like that, you got to give a lot of credit to the offensive line.
They line up at the 48. It's first down. They line up in the shotgun. 3 wide. Looking. It's broken up. Fantastic play by the cornerback.
All you young defensive backs at home, that is how you play defense.
It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 48-yard line. The Sooners come out in the ace formation. Looks to pass.
wide open. Come on.
To the 10. Touchdown. Hey, coach, was that a fine pass play or what?
Or what is right? This young man is a complete package at quarterback. He knows where his receivers will be.
All right, so I got to...
In a big, big hurry.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he converts the extra point.
Just getting to field goal range, and I should be good.
To go in the game. The score is tied up at 17. Hartley looks ready to kick this one off. Franks and Brown set to return. And it's off. Taken from the 3-yard line. So, fellas, what's your attitude at this point in this game?
There's a lot of time left, and I think the important thing for this offense is to get their momentum back and move the ball down the field.
And the quarterback has to keep his cool. These are the situations where the leaders have to calm their team down and just stick to the basics.
Tackle made at the 31. Lane comes away with 5 yards on the carry. We've got a 2nd and 5. Ball on the 31. The Aggies come out with the offset eye. McGee calls an audible. McGee takes the handoff.
Oh, my God.
Quarterback really lucked out there.
I thought they had a chance for an interception, but I'm sure they'll settle for the incompletion. It still was a good play.
5 yards.
Third down. The Aggies line up with an offset eye backfield. Alexander.
Oh my God. And a fumble.
And the defense is on it.
There's no way I did that. I was trying to cut back around, make it through this gap here. Was that a fumble? It was down already.
Late in a tie ball game like this, if they end up losing because of that fumble, this poor guy is going to be looked at as the GOAT.
Better call, yeah.
Big momentum shift could be in the making.
Ooh, I got saved.
Possible fumble.
And remember the rules of the booth review. If there is inconclusive evidence, then the call will stand.
That's pretty conclusive right there.
100% sure that the ball carry was down to overturn this call.
So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
It's 4th down. Texas A&M ready to punt this one away. Smith awaiting the return. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. Smith fields it at the 24. Throws a
step. I don't believe this. An extra 30 yards. Just because it's hard to... aim at one player.
I'll take those yards over dancing all over the place and getting nowhere any day.
The game's like winning 11. It's a soccer game. Fix this problem by you being able to focus on one player. That way you don't have to guess on where exactly the right angle is to pursue someone.
We'll see if they can capitalize on the good field position. Bradford is back in the gun. Texas A&M trying to call an audible on defense. Drops back on first down. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 44-yard line. And the completion nets him very little yardage. Coach, what's up with that play?
A lot of these guys are wearing those visors.
Got him in a hurry. No chance to get anything there.
It was a safe call on first down. You never know when someone's going to break loose and make a play.
The Sooners come out with 4 wide receivers. The quarterback's in the shotgun. Here's the option. He's taken down.
3rd and 9.
Around the 44-yard line. He got what he could, and it wasn't much. It's 3rd and 9. Ball on the 44. Single set backfield. Drop back to pass.
Come on. Of course he gets it.
Got the junior. Boy, does this kid have an arm or what?
Are you kidding me? It looks like he has a rocket launcher attached to his shoulder.
From the 34-yard line.
Okay, I got to call a timeout.
Texas A&M will take their first time out.
Can't let him run it all the way down. Might be best just to let him score.
The catch. He's going to take it to the barn. Touchdown. And coach, how about that touchdown?
With that last touchdown throw, this quarterback,
this probably wasn't the worst thing to happen. Because otherwise, it would have just ran down the clock and then kicked an easy field goal. This way, I still have a chance to get the ball back and tie the game up.
They line up for the point after.
See if I can block it. Nope.
And he adds the extra point. So we take a moment to check out the Pontiac drive summary. Oklahoma is lining up to kick this one off.
Prefer to get a good kick return here.
Back to return. Decent kick. Franks from the five. He's taken down at the 27-yard line. So what do you think about this situation, fellas?
Well, they have a little bit of time, but I think it's very crucial that they get the ball in the end zone on this possession.
I agree with you, Kirk. They can take their time, but a field goal is just about out of the question.
This drive will start at the 27. We've got a first and 10. Oklahoma put six DBs on the field to counter this five receiver look. And we got an injured player on the field. From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. Texas A&M lines up in a shotgun set. McGee drops back, rolls to the right.
Man, waiting too long.
Slow down that passing game.
Man, this defensive end does everything. When he isn't sacking a quarterback, he's knocking down passes.
Defensive ends like this one are a quarterback's worst nightmare.
Pretty obvious passing down here. The offense is faced with third and long. They come out in a five-wide set. McGee calls an audible. Drops back to pass.
Come on.
It over the middle. And they make the stop at the 38. So they keep the sticks moving on third down.
That was a great play. They still have a long way to go, though, Brad.
Yeah, but they're keeping this game exciting.
McGee set to go to the air. Rifles this one out to the left.
That was not the intended target, but I'll take it.
I'll tell you, this receiver showed really good hands on that play.
This kid is always calling for the ball, and if he keeps making plays like that, he'll continue to get the ball.
The Sooners change their defensive look.
Whoa. A deep route here.
He drops back. Steps up. Harris. Bats it down. Comes up with the interception.
Yeah, you're right. That was a pretty dangerous throw there, Lee. That ball just floated on him a little bit.
I think he tried to lob it in there, Kirk. You're right. And he was lucky that wasn't picked off.
Oklahoma brings in the nickel here. McGee calls an audible. Setting up the play action.
Oh, my God. I got lucky there.
You gotta be careful throwing in the coverage like that.
Well, coach, I don't think it was a poor decision.
I thought the DB was gonna run off. Crap.
This defense faces another third down. McGee is in the shotgun. Empty backfield. Texas A&M. Changing their play. McGee drops back to pass.
Let's it go. Interception. Uh-oh.
It's knocked loose. Incomplete. Wow.
Not a smart pass.
He thought he could squeeze it in there. I guess.
Now the next time he does that, he better be ready to make a tackle. They'll pick him off if he's not careful.
Fourth down.
I gotta make it happen here.
There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. McGee steps back to pass. Rolls to the
oh man. Oh my God. Touchdown.
So now they're only an extra point away from tying this ball game up, fellas.
That's the guy that got rocked on that punt return. Steven McGee clutch. All right, can't miss it now. Can't miss this. We got a minute 13. They line up the kick. Turn the slide on.
He kicks it off and he got all of that one. And down he goes at the 29. They're 2 for 2 in finding the end zone on their last two drives. Let's see how they do here.
And it was a really nice drive, too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
They'll get the ball here at the 29.
All right.
Oklahoma lines up in a shotgun set. Bradford back in the gun, back to pass. Knocked down, incomplete. Great range.
That's good. Let's try interception next time.
That one wasn't intercepted. It's second down and 10 to go.
He's fortunate it wasn't intercepted.
Bradford lines up under center. Three wide receivers. He drops back. He steps up. Complete. He's tackled. At about the 35. Oklahoma just took their first timeout. Third down and 4 coming up on this one. Ball on the 35-yard line. Oklahoma comes out in the shotgun. He's looking to pass.
Oh.
The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete. Now it's going to be fourth down.
Nice defense. That was picture perfect. 3 and out. Good series for these guys.
There's no way they're going to punt it. Are they going to punt it? Well, I guess, yeah.
So it's fourth down. The Sooners.
Yeah, that's the smarter thing to do.
No. Punts it. And this okay. Is a wonderful kick. Peterson.
Peterson's not getting rocked this time.
Out of bounds at the 42-yard line. It's been quite a game, fellas. We've got less than a minute left in the fourth quarter, and it's still a tie game.
I'm interested to see the strategy that this offense uses. Do you think we'll see some aggressive play calling, Kirk?
Absolutely. I know this coach, and I would be very surprised if he didn't come out firing on all cylinders.
They got two timeouts. Almost a minute.
It's first and 10, Texas A&M. Comes out with three receivers in the shotgun. McGee with the play fake.
Man.
Looking for his man. Oh, he had a shot at the pick. It was the safety that almost came up with a big play.
Not a very good read here by the quarterback.
Kirk, I don't think he even saw the safety. But this offense is lucky that he couldn't hang on to the football.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 42. The Aggies come out in a shotgun. McGee steps back to pass. He rolls left. Here they come. McGee loses the handle.
The offense was very lucky on that one.
Yeah, coach, this was a sloppy job of handling the ball.
Third and 8.
This offense, that they were,
man, that was a terrible series of play calls.
The defense could have pounced on that football.
Third and 8.
If the fullback can get free, if I don't get blitzed first.
Ah,
should have had a juke move.
At the 50, the defense calls a timeout. That was their second timeout.
Fourth and 2 on midfield. 30 seconds. I don't know. I really want to go for it here, but if I don't get it, they got 30 seconds. That's basically free field goal, so I got to punt it.
So it's fourth down. Here comes the punter looking to boot this one away. Brantley awaits the snap. Brantley.
A little too far.
This one is a skyrocket. Well, there's not that much time left, and we've still got a tie ball game.
The good teams win games like this, Brad. And at this point, it's just a matter of which team wants it most.
And this should be
game's way longer than I thought it would be.
Go with the I formation.
Bradford drops back to pass. It's complete. Brought down. At the 32. That one worked pretty well.
It's a good job here by the wide receiver to get open. He created good separation from the defense.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 32. Bradford comes up to the line with three receivers split out wide. Bradford steps back.
Oh.
Brown bats it down. The defender
keep getting these near miss interceptions.
Big time playmaker. He better start getting two hands on it.
Yeah, Lee, that ball should have been picked off there.
Texas A&M showing respect.
Just going to run it.
Back away from the coverage. Back to pass. Short pass to the left. And he's hit before he could go anywhere. As we've seen before.
Guess it's going to be overtime then.
That'll do it for regulation, and we are going to settle this one in overtime. So here's the coin toss for overtime.
If I win the coin toss, I like to put my defense out there first. That way my offense knows what it has to do when they get the football.
And it also puts added pressure on the defense to make a stop if their team didn't get a touchdown.
Hopefully staying in this cover three, a good idea.
Looks like we've got an injured player down there.
I'll take that too. They're starting running back.
Second down. The Aggies line up with six defensive backs. Two tight ends here. Patrick on the give. A little juke.
Third and one.
From the 16-yard line, third down. The defense comes up tight on the coverage. Bradford is lined.
Ooh, on an option.
Bradford with the option. A nice third down conversion there.
I set myself up for that one.
To run the football in this situation, as you can see, with good reason.
Or any situation for that matter. If I'm the coach, I'm going to run the option play over and over again until they prove to me that they can stop it.
Defense lines up with eight men in the box. Tackle around the 4-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
And it's the senior linebacker who came up with the stop.
He's always on top of the run. Not much room for the ball carrier to work on that play.
It's second down. They can smell the end zone as they line up 3 yards out. So the offense strikes first in this overtime.
Trotted right in.
Excellent job by this offense.
All right.
Get the quick score.
Now the other team has no choice but to go for six. Field goals are out of the question now.
So they're ready for the extra point. Kicks away, and he adds the extra point. And here's the Pontiac drive summary.
All right.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 25. The Aggies line up with an offset eye backfield. On the ground with a tailback. He's tackled Reynolds around the 23-yard line. He gains a couple of yards on the carry. It's second and 8. McGee comes to the line under center. He has two backs behind him. Lane again, and he's taken down at the 18-yard line. 5 yards.
5-yard gain on the play.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Texas A&M sets up in the eye. McGee hands off, and down he goes, right around the 12-yard line. Good run by the halfback. Be good enough to move the chains.
Not a bad run at all. He came away with 5 or 6 yards, and this offense will take that every single time.
I don't have to throw it this time. I'm not going to do it.
They hand it off again. He got hit hard. Lane picks up 2 yards with a carry.
And he took a shot on that play, Brad. It looks like his head might be still ringing a little bit.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 10-yard line. Texas A&M comes out with an eye formation.
Ooh.
So with their backs against the wall, they find a way.
Jaworski Lane. I think they call him J Train. Back when he played.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he tacks on the extra point. And now we'll take a look at the Pontiac drive summary.
A second overtime. Are you ready for this, coach?
Oh, you know I'm ready.
I think I have to go first this time.
Is this defense ready? I think if they can hold them to a field goal, they'll get the win. That's my call.
They'll line up at the 25. First down. McGee is lined
up. I don't think my best player out here is Jaworski Lane, so he's going to get those touches.
Lane on the inside handoff. Tackle made at the 16-yard line. Gain of 9.
9-yard gain on the play.
It's second down and a yard to go. Ball on the 16. McGee is under center.
Oh my God.
Recovers a loose ball.
Yep. Was he down? Looky, look down. It's gonna be another play. Play call reversed. Better be. Oh, they're gonna call it there. Come on, you gotta look at that again. Yeah, he's down. That's so not a fumble. You better reverse that.
First down.
Oh my God. Can I call a challenge or something? There's no way. Just got robbed of a possession there.
The Sooners line up with four wideouts. They go with the option, and they got him for a loss. Well, they just couldn't get much of anything there.
No, Brad, he couldn't. And I think the offensive line's going to have to hold their blocks longer than they did on that play.
They line up at the 26. It's second down. Bradford lines up.
Oh my God. Come on. Come on. Come on. Some redemption here. Come on, number 25.
He's all the way. Touchdown.
That Wrecking Crew defense. What a way to end it. There it is. Ooh.
Here's the Pontiac game-changing performance from today's game.
Got a pick six, room service touchdown. Unbelievable.
Of NCAA football 2008. And our final score in this one, the Texas A&M Aggies 37 and the Oklahoma Sooners 31.
Kyle Field looks great. Old school Kyle Field.
And Kirk Herbstreit. EA Sports, thanks you for playing, and we'll see you next time.
Check out these stats. Not these. Stephen McGee went from 100% down to 55. No interceptions, though. Average 10-yard pass. I mean, that's like averaging a first yard every pass. Got sacked 3 times. Pretty decent spread here. Got 2 sacks. Oh no, that's blocking. They got 2 sacks on them. Mark Dodge is right outer linebacker, defensive tackle, 2 sacks. Let's see what Sam Bradford did. 14 out of 23, 60%. 211 yards. Not too much rushing. I lost 2 fumbles. One of them there at the end was definitely not a fumble, but I guess the game thought it was. Lost 2 fumbles, and they lost 2 interceptions. We were even in turnovers. And of course, I won the TOP. I need to see that again. It looks like I'm in the 4-2-5. I think Bradford probably should have lobbed it here. Because if he did, I mean, his receiver might have been able to catch that with the high arc. Yeah, his best bet might have been not to even throw the ball. He could have scrambled here for a decent little gain. I guess they would have called this roughing the passer in today's game. Ooh, it was close here. Man. Well, great game. And once you get into it, I mean, instead of Leo 8, pretty decent game. You know, the gameplay, I think, is pretty solid. It's a little janky in some areas. You know, some of the newer NCAA games are smoother in some ways. But this game definitely had a good gameplay flow that felt like it was grounded, you know. But that's about it, guys. Have a good one. Hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you all in the next one.